This is Keith Berkelhammer, and this is Reef Bum TV. Is good polyp extension necessary if you want to have success with SPS corals? Not necessarily. However, if you dig those fuzzy sticks, then there are a few things you can do to fulfill this desire. Here are my top 5 tips for maximizing SPS polyp extension. Number 1. Avoid fish with a hankering for SPS. Perhaps this is a no-brainer, but you should bypass fish with a tendency to snack on SPS. Certain angelfish can be problematic. For example, dwarf or pygmy angels are known to nip and are high risk. Angels such as swallowtail or Bellis angels are considered reef safe. Number 2. Maintain good water conditions. This is really two parts, but I'm wrapping them into one because I want a top 5 list, not a top 6 list. Part 1 is to keep your parameters steady. It is critical to have stability for things such as salinity, nitrate, magnesium, and calcium. Stable phosphate is important as well, but perhaps most important for SPS is keeping alkalinity at a constant level. Any swings with this parameter over a short period of time usually spells trouble and can impact polyp extension. As for part 2, keep a slightly dirty tank and have some levels of nitrates, I recommend anywhere between 2.5 and 5 parts per million, and some phosphates in the 0.03 to 0.05 part per million range. You don't want to starve your corals with non-detectable nutrients. Number 3, provide strong random flow. To replicate what happens in nature, give SPS strong random flow using a good recirculation pump. Proper circulation helps to deliver food and nutrients to coral, but don't go overboard and blast SPS with constant, full-on direct flow. Number 4, be mindful of lighting requirements. SPS corals with low light requirements placed under high light will not be happy campers. By the same token, corals that thrive under strong light will not do as well when placed in spots with less light intensity. And finally, number 5, keep an eye out for pests. SPS will become stressed when acro-eating flatworms or red bugs are in the house. Red bugs are easily eradicated, but nuking those acro-eating flatworms is much more difficult. These tips will certainly increase your odds of having better SPS polyp extension, and some will lead to more overall success with SPS. For a complete list of how to optimize SPS colors and growth, you can check out my top 10 tips for keeping an SPS reef tank by clicking on the link at the top of this video. Or you can grab a copy of my book by clicking on the other link. Many thanks for watching, and please don't forget to hit that subscribe button to be alerted to my latest videos.